Just months before this historic landing, a prototype LEM was flight tested at Ellington Air Force Base. While NASA cameras record the test flight, Neil Armstrong struggles to control the unwieldy craft. Then, at approximately 300 feet, the lander flies wildly out of control. At the last second, Armstrong ejects. And floats to safety.
99, proceeded, 3, 2, 1, ignition. Run away, Houston. Vector good. X spot. Pitch over. That's here, you have good thrust.
130, Houston, we're in the blind and we'll go.
Roger, we'd like the eggs to auto. Challenger, Houston, we'd like to turn.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
This is,
we have ignition.
What a liftoff.
And liftoff.
Roger, ignition.
Boom. Pitch over. 10 seconds.
Roger.
Hey, baby. That's good.
Before this historic landing, a prototype LEM was flight tested at Ellington Air Force Base. While NASA cameras record the test flight, Neil Armstrong struggles to control the unwieldy craft. Then, at approximately 300 feet, the lander flies wildly out of control. At the last second, Armstrong ejects. And floats to safety. If the lander was so unstable and difficult to fly in the controlled environment of Earth, then how could the LEM land 6 times flawlessly in the alien environment of the moon?
The LEM had a single engine mounted dead center, and then they had little push jets, thruster jets, a couple of them up on top. This was supposed to control their attitude as they came down. Well, I'll tell you a secret. The instant you moved your tail in that cabin an inch, you would change the load pattern, it would begin to tilt, and it would start that thing spinning.
In the footage of the ascent stage going up, what you don't see is an exhaust plume coming out of the rocket engine nozzle. But what do we see? We see the ascent stage suddenly pop up without any exhaust plume whatsoever, as though it were jerked up by a cable.
We've all been led to believe that on July 20th, 1969, the Lunar Excursion Module, also known as the LEM, carried American astronauts to the surface of the moon. But could it have simply been a prop lowered by wires onto a movie set? Bill Kasing says that this may explain the absence of engine noise in the official NASA footage.
The noise level of a rocket engine is up into the 140, 150 decibel range. In other words, enormously loud.
how would it be possible to hear astronauts' voices against the background of a running rocket engine?
Picking up some dust. 3 feet, 2.5 down. Straight shadow. 4 forward, drifting to the right a little. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
Is this evidence that the footage is actually fake? A sequence shot in a controlled environment here on Earth?
The surface appears to be very fine-grained as you get close to it. It's almost like a powder.
To have a powerful rocket engine blast the surface of the moon, blasting away all of the dust, and then find footprints surrounding the lunar lander, that to me would be an impossibility.
Photo after photo reveals that the lunar surface surrounding the LEM is covered with footprints. But Casing says there's something even more difficult to explain.
The fact that there's no blast crater under the LEM is one of the most conclusive pieces of evidence that I find supporting the hoax.
In fact, no sign of a blast crater is visible for any of the 6 lunar landings. But LEM specialist Paul Fiel says he can explain why the lunar module left no crater when landing on the moon.
The amount of thrust that you need coming out of the bottom of the descent engine is about 1,500, 2,000 pounds of thrust. And all that does is just push dust away. There's no burning or anything like that.
Yet NASA's own scientific illustrations clearly depict a blast crater.
Then there's one other point. If they had truly landed on the moon, this dust would have then descended on the lunar lander, on the foot pads, and we find not a trace of dust on the foot pads. When I discovered that alone, I said, no way am I looking at a lunar lander that landed on the moon.
Could it be that the LEM was just a prop on a giant lunar movie set?